Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell with MrCampbellRocks.com here with another tutorial. They have updated Google Meet today. I'm going to show you how to or what the update looks like. So what it does is it protects the group Meet and the basically creator of the group Meet, whether that's through calendar or meet.google.com, from having extra people jump in after the meeting is over. So I've actually joined this on my phone. And I kind of want to show you what this looks like when you're done. The message that you're going to get if you try and enter after the meeting is this message that the meeting code doesn't work. Now, there is a little bit of a lag time, right? And we did this at school today, so it's maybe a minute, 30 seconds. So what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to remove on the phone down here from the meeting. You should just see my desktop now on my phone. And then what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to end the meeting too as well. And so I'll just close this out. Now, if I try and open this back up, you can see on my phone, right, that it just went to a regular browser. I'm going to go back in a couple minutes and try and type that back in. When we finish the meeting, one of our biggest worries was that students are going to come back in. And so if I were to take that code, if I just open up Google again and we'll just go history here. We'll just go to our last meeting here. It's still going to let me join. And so maybe we need to wait just a little bit longer for that. But the message that you're going to get is the one that I showed you earlier. And it's the screenshot that I shared is right here. So this is what you'll get once your meeting ends. And you'll also get this when you try and enter from a cellular device. So what I'm going to try and do is pick up my phone now and jump back in that meeting that we had, which is here. ECB-QYGU-UOG. We'll come back over here. You can see here. So we've got that typed in again on my phone here. So when we click the check mark, it's going to say that that's not available. So on the phone, it's not available, and I've typed it in correctly. There you can see, right? The server can't be found. So let's go back over here one more time on the computer and see if we can jump back in. And you'll see. So it was about 2 minutes of a lag time before students. So my recommendation, right, is once you close the meeting is to just go back and check maybe 2 minutes after to see if that meeting is still closed. Again, this tutorial is to show you what happens after you close a meeting in Google Meet. Now you're going to get this message, which doesn't allow anybody back into the meeting. If you found value in this meeting, if it saved you time, energy, or stress or worry about people coming in after, again, we'd love for you to subscribe and like and do all those things that you do on YouTube videos, but share it with others because they probably have the same question. That's the question that came up when we were doing this. So I love you. I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.